Hello, welcome back to Let's Play the Darkside Detective, and this stuff's loud again as usual. There we go. Okay. So we've solved all the regular cases, so the credits, and now there's bonus cases. So let's check out Buy Hard. Christmas Eve is the perfect time for some last-minute shopping, right? Maybe not. Buy Hard. Christmas-themed. Twin Lakes Mall. Woo! Christmas Eve. Perfect for some last-minute holiday shopping. When I was a kid, holiday shopping meant buying new trunks for the beach. Who's this kid, Buzz? I didn't notice him standing there. When you were a kid, something something, old people, let's go see Santa. Whose kid is that? I can't wait to watch movies and eat candy all day. Ahem. And help my mom with dinner. Okay, I guess that's Dooley's kid? That's scary that he has a kid, though. I hope Santa got my letter. Parking lot is that way. Got an entrance. Got lights that we can look at. It's not time to go back to the car yet. Well, damn it, let's go inside then. JV, halt, shoppers. What is the nature of your visit? Another robot voice. Shopping. Shopping for last-minute Christmas gifts, clearly. Your story checks out. Just remember, I am the law around here, and my cameras cover 26% of this place. Not everything happens without my knowing about it. Security bot. Warning, do not do a crime, shoppers. A crime is for life, not just the holidays. Okay, decorations? They've really gone all out this year. I know, much better than last year's lone light and cardboard tree. You can really smell the plastic off this one. I do love me some Christmas music. I know, buddy. You've been playing them in the car since Halloween. Yeah, you're right. I did leave it pretty late to start this year. Can I have one of those for Christmas? No way, mister. Last year you got a robot and forgot to take care of it. I ended up having to wash it for you. Hey, that's why it short-circuited. That's not the way to Santa's grotto. Fine. Dooley, don't go in there. Oh, so now we're good too. Now we're too good to search in bins all of a sudden. I can't look at the tree. Escalator. Info point. Thank goodness there's a map. These places are huge. I always get lost. Dooley, the mall is only 20 screens big. Is it really 20 screens big? Okay, look at these decorations. Where to first, detective? Well, ground floor has the food court, fountain, and arcade. Upstairs are the shops and the cinema. Grotto and Santa are over here. Come on, guys. I guess we keep going to the grotto for now. Which is... food court? This guy up. Why is the grotto so far in? If it was here, we'd be there by now. Gah! Are you thinking what I'm thinking? You know it. Photo montage. Oh, jeez. Dorks. Again? Okay. Ground floor is the food court. What if we don't? What if we want to take the escalator up? That's not the way to Santa's grotto. Fine. Okay. Food court. Newspaper stand. A free copy of the Twin Lake Times. Grab me a copy, will you? I want to read the sports results. Got the newspaper. So Dooley can read? This week's sporting news. I see the Spider Moth coach is blaming their losing streak on a hex. I should probably investigate that, actually. Menu. Hot dogs, burgers, turkey legs. It all sounds so delicious, I don't know what to order. Yous can ignore us all that. We's got stew. Oh, it's Chef Agnes from the one with the camp. The campsite. What? It's a hearty winter treat. What flavor is it? Dunno. Can just said stew. I'll just have a soda. Ain't got no sodas. Only got stew. Fizzy stew. I didn't think it was possible, but I've lost my appetite. I wasn't hungry until this screen loaded. And now you're not hungry again. If Uncle Patrick stops for food, we'll never get to the grotto in time to see Santa. Patrick Dooley. Okay, so there's Norman, Agnes, Eggnog Stall, Milky Egg Liquid, The Taste of the Holidays. Anything else to look at? Not really. Nothing else of use here now. Agnes? What are you doing here? I works here when the camps is closed. The camp closes? I need to make a few phone calls. Devin's waiting out here. He'll be here any minute, right? Armelia says, no, Devin. No, he won't. That means Christmas abandonment badges. Yay! Didn't mean to do that. Norman? Need some eggnog, mate? We have all the varieties. Egg-flavored, nog-flavored, milk-flavored? Okay, off to the fountain. He won't let us even go back from a screen that we've been to. Ned's gardening. How pretty. Whoa! That is impressive. It goes as far as the eye can see. Dooley, it doesn't even touch the root. As far as the eye can see. Whatever. Those decorations are pretty impressive, right, Dooley? That's nothing compared to the tree I'm decorating when I get home tonight. Wait, it's Christmas Eve and you don't have a tree up yet? I think you'll find I have 7 up so far, but for tonight's tree, I'm pulling out all the stops. I've never seen a bidet with that much power before. Okay, so what it is, dude. Yeah, the grotto is right over there. They must have been growing this here in secret for ages. Or they brought it in through the skylight. Growing for the longest time. My gifts better be as big as the ones under that tree, Uncle Patrick. They're almost as big as you are, Buzz. Oh, is it? Oh, wait. Okay, so he's... Alright, so he's the uncle. That's not anybody's kid. He's here. It says that's his nephew. Alright. And? Free gifts. Our job here is done. Nope, they're empty. On we go. Alright, to the grotto. He won't let us go back, right? Just wanted to see. Detective, don't lick that place. Why would I lick it? Well, it looks like gingerbread. Yeah, but just because it looks like gingerbread doesn't mean it's... You licked it, didn't you? It looks just like the gingerbread. Why are we wasting all this time standing around? There's a Santa in there that needs clawsing. Is that... whatever. It's all I hope for and more. Let's go! Happy Elf. Oh, there's an arcade over there. Welcome to Santa's Grotto, where all your dreams come true. Roll on quitting a clock. Not the way to Santa's Grotto. Not this way. That's not the way to Santa's Grotto. Alright, so we have to go inside. Alright, so there's nothing else to look at out here. Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas, one and all! The Jolly Red Meal Ticket! Look at this fine trio of lads. I hope you've been good all year. Good? We've been great. We need some city-saving-sized goodies in the stocking this year, Santa. A city saver, eh? Then you must be Detective McQueen. I kid. I know who you are, Francis. I am Santa. I see all. I was just being a jerk for funsies. Guys, Santa's got a busy schedule. Join the queue and wait your turn, yeah? Okay, Buzz, you heard the happy elf. Get in the queue and we'll go grab gifts for you and your mom. Are we okay to leave him here on his own? Detective, it's Twin Lakes, at Christmas. What could possibly go wrong? Oh yeah, well, we're leaving him anyway. Uncle of the Year here. Okay, so Dooley's his uncle. So confused. Who? Where? Maybe I can get some tips, because I suspect I need him. I saw him once, you know, as a kid. Christmas of 47. What? Yeah, he was on trial, and my father, a small-time lawyer... Dooley, I'm going to stop you right there. Your dad was a history professor in TLU. You're telling me the plot to Miracle on 34th Street. Huh. I guess that explains why I remember it all in black and white. Guys, get out of here. You're embarrassing me in front of Father Capitalism. Nervous kid. I hope my hands thaw out before I meet Santa. I'd hate to accidentally drop my gift. Or worse, give a weak handshake. You only get one first impression. Ear muffled kid. Oh, it's Kenny. You're next, kid. What? I said you're next. Okay, mister. Just let me know when I'm next. I can't wait. Happy elf. Form an orderly queue, children and, bigger children. I hate my life. Santa. Let me look at Santa's room. That is one fancy seat. Cup holder, heated seat, back massager. It has all the functions. It has to be, in case he needs to, go, you know, on the job. Santa's pile of gifts. Hey, detective, if we confiscated those, we'd have our shopping done in the time it takes to properly fill out Form J-37. Tempted as I am, I don't think your sister will dig a pile of poorly made kids' toys. The happy elf says, hey, that all took me hours to make. Anything else to look at? No, we'll talk to Santa. What a good pair of boys you two are, saving the city week in and out. Wait, how do you know about all that? Let's just say, wink. Wait, who's the one who said wink? I hate when people say wink. You can blame the low resolution for that. Alright, let's go. Alright, let's go to the arcade. Why would anyone want to alarm a fire? Those things are dangerous when spooked. Bin? Must we search every bin we see? Yes. Faith invaders. Seriously? How do I move? Can I use the... Oh, really? How do I... Seriously? Oh, okay, space bar to fire. Pretty funny. I'm gonna get rid of all of them. You could shoot faster than actual space invaders, that I remember anyway. I mean, you could get another shot off before that one gets off the screen, I'm pretty sure. And the original Space Invaders, and all the ones I can remember, you have one shot on the screen at a time. Oh, I've got that in the way. Let's get rid of these. It is speeding up, I can tell that. Oh, I can actually shoot the bullets out. Or whatever it's firing. That's not effective. Try to clear out this level. Boop. Alright. I'm good. What happens if we die, like all our lives here? Let's just let myself get killed again. Game over! That's quite... That's fun. Zombie Munch. Seriously, Pac-Man? Oh my god. This is awesome. Too bad it doesn't make the sounds. So they're all appropriately spookily oriented. I wonder if we have the fruit that shows up here every once in a while. It wouldn't be a fruit, would it? And instead of the power pills, we have actual, like, meds. Capsule form. How do I get up there? Get up there! No! That's tricky! They didn't put these in the right spot. It's really hard to get... It's hard to turn in this, that's the only problem. Wait, I can't go back that way now? Oh. Gotcha! I'm just gonna be inefficient here and do that. They don't chase after you, that makes it easier. Wow, this is like a super easy Pac-Man, actually. I've never been, like, so good at Pac-Man before. Whoop! 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 Let's clear these out. Super easy. That is not going to stay blue long enough with it. Nope! I'm almost done with this level. Just going to clear this out. Oh, and it just ends then. Okay. We've got the claw machine. Why is there a kid in here? Pete says he crawled in when I wasn't looking. Was a kid inside there? But Dada, little Jimmy says, you told me to go in and pass the goodies out to you. Shut up! Kids, eh? Say the damnedest things. Emily? Well, it's Emily, the fire starter, the twisted fire starter. Pete, broken console. It's out of order. Aw, Rampaging Monkey is my favorite game here. Hey, Detective. Hey, Blood Alpha. Emily, what are you doing here? Dad took me and my baby brother to see Santa, but Santa is lame, so now we're trying to steal toys from the claw machine. Excited for Christmas? Ugh, I hate Christmas. Everyone is off with their families, the weather is poop, and we have to go around with Dad stealing stuff to put under the tree. Rubbish time of year. What about Santa? Surely you're excited for his visit? Santa's a sham, Detective. Sometimes I worry about your deductive skills. Maybe if you were nicer and didn't rob arcades, he'd visit. I don't see how those things are linked. Did you ask Santa for anything nice? That chump doesn't write to me, so I don't write to him. Besides, it's a bit grand, isn't it? Flying all over the world giving kids gifts? What past crime are you trying to cover up, Crimson Pants? See you guys later. Alright, Pete? Hey, buddy. Can't you see him busy stealing... Oh, hello, officer. So, nothing else in here. I like the games. It's a nice touch. I should actually play them. Now, before... Oh, did I talk to him in here? The arcade is the most wonderful place on Earth. I loved arcades as a kid. Okay, I still love them. Can we go? Can we? Can we? Can we? We just did. If he has anything different to say. Or for anyone that has anything different to say here. Sorry. This time you don't get called dorks, though. I hope Santa got my letter. It's not time to go back to the car yet. All right. Let's go upstairs. Oh, wait, we haven't got up this escalator. Oh! What was that? Screen shake. We better go make sure Buzz is okay. Or we can just go up to here. Tech stop. TV screen. Ho, ho, ho. Merry Bimass. Don't forget to ask your parents for all the biggest toys this Christmas, children. No expense is too much if they love you. Nailed it in one. Brickman's Christmas Roundup, bringing you the top news and events of the past year. Oh, I love this show. I wonder if we'll get a mention. Dick Brickman says, you do not. Aw, no fair. This TV has a printout of a newsroom where the glass should be. Catamon, Catamon, she will fight the cosmic star. Her claws are made from tears of moon, projecting daylight from Singuri 5. She pleasures licks of fury. Foreign cartoons are odd. I just gotta lean into the oddness is all. Open your heart to it. Guess so. Oh, my favorite show is on. That's the local bus times. And? There's a lot to see and do around the city, Detective. You should hop on a random bus yourself someday. Okay, so we can go into the tech store. Rico says, what other features would you like to see? Elgar says, can it look up the sports results? Of course. Just open this menu, scroll to here, type in all your personal data, and then ask your question. Using 32 characters or less, including spaces. Then your question is then sent to the Encyclopedia Britannica headquarters, where a person looks it up and replies. There we go. Sent. Now we just wait for the answer. This may take a few units of time. Okay. I love this place. I wonder what new gadgets or we can find to rig out the Popomoto with. Come on, Dooley. I just get the hang of using the police scanner. Such a Luddite, Detective. True. I put the no in technology. They shouldn't sell detonation equipment in a place like this. Boombox. I prefer to clean my vacuums by hand. These are just like the cameras we use to tell if the area is high crime or not. The ones that they wall mount and count the number of days until somebody steals them? The very same. Wow, it's so big you can almost see the pixels. Sports fan. There's a lamp. Radio. We're still investigating video's crime against you, sir. Your video killed a radio star. Lamp. These are the same lamps we have in the station's interrogation cells. Alright, sports fan. Do you know the sports results? Trademark. All I want is to know how sports did this season. Sports salesman. Where are my sports results? They're on the way. Just gotta have a little patience. Okay. Don't ever ask me to sing again. Wait, you didn't ask me to sing in the first place. Alright, so there's nowhere else to go in here. The toy store is this way. The little kid can take care of himself. These robots make great gifts. Hint. They're like little sidekicks. A demi-sidekick. Almost like a sidekick for your sidekick. Hint, hint. Next you're gonna say wink. I want one. Hint. For Christmas. Hint, hint. I feel like that bear is staring right into my soul. A friendly dinosaur? Clearly these guys weren't junior paleontologists like me. Trying to ascribe human traits to reptiles? Typically human-centric notions. Oh yes, this is my favorite store. What did he say outside here? Did he say anything? No, wait, this is my favorite store. This one. This is the one. I love them all, okay? It's candy and tech and cinema toys. What am I meant to do? I'm only human. Oh, now he doesn't say anything. I broke Dooley. Dooley's broken. He's Dooley broken. I've never seen a person smile that much while also crying. I just love my job so much. The constant shrill of children laughing, hearing the toys repeat the same stock phrases, the bear whispering dark thoughts in my ear. It's a kind of paradise. A kind of one. Action figures. Okay, looks like, Skeletor and He-Man. Leaders of the Multiverse action figures. Only wears Pants Man and his arch-nemesis, skull for a face but otherwise not a skeleton. Buzz would love these if they came with their Fortress Beige Skull playset instead of Fortress Gray Skull. Puzzle Rectangle. A painfully colorful puzzle. What I'd give to go into space, huh? Timon? The dark isolation of space. No kids, no toys, no toys, no lights. A limited supply of air. Oh man, I love this guy. Undisputed king of the dinosaurs, and dinosaurs didn't even observe political hierarchies or dynasties. Ah, jump ropes. Trying to trick kids into exercising since man invented rope. Rope is always useful, so I'll grab some of this, if you don't mind. Huh. Me complain? Not in front of the bear. No siree. Alright, we still stole some jump rope. A length of rope with handles at each end. Truck Tycoon? I know these toys. Buzz collects them. They're robots that turn into slightly different-looking robots. Oh yes, I see. This one changes from a truck with a container into a truck without a container. The stuff of wonders. What a country this was way back when men were men and didn't take orders from stuffed teddy bears. The bear doesn't say anything. I'm sorry, Mr. Bear. I know you only make me do these things as punishment. For my own good, yes siree. Brontosaurus. An orange Brontosaurus. Why don't you just give him a rocket pack if you're gonna make stuff up? Jeez. A tea set? I know. I'd love to sit for a cup of tea too, Dooley. But not until we make sure Buzz is okay. I'm holding you to that. Do. Tea party table. Looks like a normal table to me. Don't be silly. Would a normal table cost that much? The price tag is how you know it's special. A very fancy chair. Sturdy, too. Easy bake oven. I would have thought baking an oven was anything but easy, but to start with, how would it fit in itself? Oh, jeez. Teddy bear. Please don't take the last piece of rope. I might need it. Get it. I didn't mean to hit that. Alright, let's look at the bear. Haha, this guy tells me what to do, and folks, let me tell you, it is not always pleasant. Isn't Christmas great? Chirpy music all season, and so many flashing lights, I'm constantly disoriented. I can't recall the last time I saw daylight. Okay, the bear tells him what to do, though. I was kind of wondering if something would come of that. Alright. Never mind. There's no way I'm doing that. Gardening this way. Oh, exciting. Oh, wait. I wanted to take that. I wanted to look at that anyway. Can't. Alright. Tree top. An impressive star. There seems to only actually be four shops in this mall. Something for everyone, so. Is he still broken over here? With this? No. Pretty much. It is an impressive. What's that called? Reach? Spray? Plumage? Ned's gardening. Candy store. Balcony. The tree and fountain are below us and in front of us. I guess it's all a matter of perspective. Gardening, got stuff. Wind chimes. Whittled by rare Tibetan metal peckers, like woodpeckers but for metal, and from Tibet. Picked them up when I was hiking for Mildred, of course. She came home alone. She shacked up with a monk. Holy man, my eye. Shovels, perfect for landscaping and burying bad mistakes. Like Mildred? He was part of a pair, but they were torn apart by economical differences. He's jealous of the up-top gnomes, but that's not going to get him anywhere, is it? Gnome couple. Look at that happy couple. A power couple in the world of gnomes. Weeping cacti, bred them myself. Well, with Jorge back in our horticultural days, I don't like to think about then. I don't like to think about then such heartbreak. A rubber hammer. The soft head means it's perfect for mildly smashing glass or knocking in tent pegs without bending them. Makes for a great camping mallet. Unless you come up against bears, then the soft head will let you down. Sometimes at night I still hear Derek's screams. This might let me free Emily's brother. Mind if I take it, Ned? Emily's brother needs to be freed? Something tells me we're supposed to check out something before we went here. What? Oh, yes, yes. Sorry, I got to reminiscing there. Okay, so we got a hammer. We're not supposed to know that Emily's brother needs help, I don't think. I'm not gonna sing that. I love that song, but I can never remember the words. You just said the words, didn't you? Daisies ain't a fancy plant, that's for sure, but they're sturdy. Add a nice smell and color to a place, too. Can't go wrong with a daisy, no sir. Unless you mean Daisy Miller. Girl broke my heart, that she did. Ooh-wee, I'll have my revenge one day, you mock my words. What? Oh, nothing. Just flower talk. I won't lie, I thought I was buying something else at the time. In my defense, a nightclub is a strange place to sell pottery at 2 a.m. Stack of pots. Watering can. Don't even ask about the watering can. That relationship still has me tender. A trowel. Child's shovel or a pocket spade, depending on your country of origin. A hose? That's second hand, for my old car washing business. The fun John, Tanya, and I had that summer splashing one another unexpectedly. Then, of course, they ran off with each other, and that was the end of that. Oh, jeez. You don't have a lot of good luck with relationships, do you? Plant box? Alright, so we'll finally talk to him. Dooley? I went to school with Ned. Ned the Nerd, we called him. Well, hey there, Patrick. Nice to see you in the store again. More seeds for the Blood Wolves? Not today, thanks. But we'll be by in spring for bird feeder material. I've already put in the order. You and those kids really brighten my heart. Thanks, Ned. What? I've grown a lot since then. Ned's the name. Gardening's my game. That and bridge. Can't beat an old four-way of a Thursday night. This is my shop, built from a lifetime of memories. Most good, some bad, but that's life, right? Okay. That's no way to spend Christmas Eve. What, with a hammer and a newspaper? Candy store, yay! Shop sign. No way, we have to go in. We have to. Oh, he doesn't say anything. I guess this is also one of his favorite stores. Oh, Smithy's here. And McNugget and Rose. Who's Rose? Can I look at this candy and it's... Alright, so I can only talk to them. And go in, of course. Balcony, you can't look at. Great to see you out and about, Brigadier. You too, old chap. After that run-in with old Jerry, I decided it was time to leave that hut and see what life here in the colonies had to offer. How are you finding it? Well, I joined this mall-walking club, but all we do is stand around while Rose here gives Roger cookie dough and goo-goo eyes. I need some real action. Frontline stuff. Dooley says you can come teach the Blood Wolves some survival tactics. Fight some wolves, you say? Count me in. McNugget? Detective, I haven't seen you since you ruined my pre-retirement party. Pre-retirement? Pre-retirement, an early party in case you don't make it through those last few days. Oh yeah, sorry about that. It's okay. When I was your age, I was a maverick too. Don't let the rules get you down. Speaking of rules, should you still have your sidearm? Yes, sir, rules. Out the window with them. That's my motto. But your gun. Like samurai, you and I. Following our own path. Making our own way. And Rose? Om nom nom. Oh, A gentleman caller, and here's me stuffing my face with cookie dough. Don't stop on my account. Would you like some? No, thank you. So that way is the cinema, and in here's a candy store. Candy canes! I want! Wilsa says, no chance. That's like a nightstick for your teeth. Gotta keep those smiles fresh when you're in the paper for capturing bad guys. Jars of candy. So many types of candy, I want to try them all. Heavens no, not for you. Gotta keep you boys in blue, nice and fit. Can't have crime able to outrun you. This is a wonderland. Boys, don't touch them cakes. There's calories in that icing you don't need. Oh boy. You should not be working in a place like this. Cotton candy mix. Having trouble getting your children sticky enough? Not if you give them Candy Flu's cotton candy mix. Gloop guaranteed. Just add water. Candy heart. I love candy and I love to share it with the world. Except you. For your own good, of course. I'm so conflicted about this. Lollipops. Now, something like this is more your style. You can keep it in your pocket, take it out on break, have a little lick, and put it back in for tomorrow. A lolly like that should last you a month if you control yourself. You can share one, a side each. Oh, brother. Anything else to look at? Salesperson. My, my. Two of TLPD's finest in my store. Woo-wee. For you, everything's on the house. I mean, as far as just the lollipops, right? Yes! Or at least it would be if I sold healthy foodstuffs. Can't have you two bastions of the law getting unfit on my watch. Oh no. Aww. Alright, we're done in here then, I guess. To the cinema!